Today, we're going to make a coat rack, or I guess in this case, an apron rack. We have a ton of aprons in the shop, and they're just barely hanging on a couple of these magswitches. It does not work well, so today we're going to fix that. So out of the scrap bin, we've got a piece of oak that we're going to mark just shy of the width of the door. We've also got a handful of padauk cutoffs from a previous project. After a quick Google search, I was inspired to draw up this shape. And I did it on some MDF because the original plan was to use this to pattern route the other padauk pieces, but they ended up being a little too small for me to feel comfortable doing that, so I ended up just using this to trace the outline. So yes, there is a lot of sanding in this project. I will try to skip through most of it. The boards had been previously milled, but I wanted to just clean them up real quick. They had been sitting a while, got a little wonky, and they get that like white powdery stuff that padauk sometimes gets. Do you know what I'm talking about? If anybody knows what that's from, please leave a comment below, because that's the weirdest thing. After the milling, it's over to the table saw, where I'm cutting them down to 2 inches wide. Since I'm not pattern routing these, I want to use two of the edges to line up the pattern. I'm registering this pattern off of the bottom closest towards me and the back to my right side. That way I know those are going to be flat and square, and then I really just have to dress it up. To make sure the length and that top angle are consistent, I decided to do this first step on the miter saw with a stop block. Then on the bandsaw, I'm going to cut that front curve and the two angles on the back that kind of mimic that front curve. If you're liking this video, be sure to hit that like button, and I'm going to do a lot more projects this year, so be sure to hit that subscribe button. Then I just had to put on some music and do a bunch of sanding. I started off on the spindle sander, getting that inside curve right, and then finished off on the belt sander to get those nice flat back edges. I'm not sure what this oak had been used for. It had this one stained black edge. It didn't really need milling, but I decided to mill it anyway just to clean that up and make sure it was a consistent width all the way across. I had done a rough layout earlier, but the pieces ended up a little undersized after milling. So at this point, I did a final layout to make sure I still liked the spacing of everything. And then I transferred those layout lines down to the edge of the piece so that I could glue and attach all of the padauk and not have to worry about trying to sand in between there and get those pencil lines off. This did end up meaning the board needed to get trimmed just a little bit, but that wasn't a big deal. So then it was back to the drum sander to remove all of those lines on the face and give it a nice final sanding so I wouldn't have to worry about it later. In between all those little padauk pieces, that would have been a nightmare. Since we're putting this on a big steel door, we can't really use screws to hold it up. So I'm gonna drill a hole with a Forstner bit, and we're gonna insert those mag switches from earlier so they can still be used to hold the aprons up, but this time it'll be way more functional. Now we need to attach those pieces of padauk, and I'm using the layout lines on the edge of the piece along with my square to make sure everything's nice and straight and spaced out exactly how I wanted it. I'm just doing a rub joint on all of these pieces because while the glue will provide some structural integrity, it's really just there to hold all the pieces in place long enough for me to get a couple screws in the back. I've got this nice bit that's supposed to pre-drill and countersink all at once. But between the oak and the padauk, it clogged up so frequently that I ended up pretty much having to drill every hole twice anyway. And yes, I realize these screws are absolutely massive for this. I think they were like number 10 by 1.5. But it was the only thing we had in the shop that was bigger than like 3/4 of an inch, which wouldn't have even gone through the oak. I did not feel like stopping at this point to go get different screws. So now we get to put it up and try it out and make sure that the two mag switches can manage to hold up the whole coat rack and all of these aprons. And I had my doubts, but honestly, it worked perfectly. Although, this may be a sign that we need to do some spring cleaning and get rid of some of these aprons. Alright, we can see the finish line, and all the pieces are already sanded, but I did discover while hanging up all those aprons that the edges were very sharp. So we're just gonna break the edges a little bit, and then it's on to finishing. And if you watch our stuff, you know me, you know one of my favorite finishes is Osmo. And that's what we're using. We've got the Osmo Gloss, just because I thought, you know, the bright oak and the padauk could use a little pop. I'm gonna be honest, I was not sure how I felt about the combo. We just picked these because they were scrap wood in the scrap bin. But I gotta say, really like the combo of the wood. The oak and the padauk looks really nice together. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to hit that like button and subscribe for more. Do you like the padauk oak combo? Let me know in the comments.